I don't.
I don't. Love you, man.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Y'all can be seated. All right. Okay, we are gathered here in the sight of God for the purpose of seeing Xavion Johnson and Amanda McIntyre in holy matrimony. The Word of the Living God teaches us that marriage is to be honorable, that it is a holy estate ordained of God and to be held in honor by all. We are assembled here today in the presence of God to witness this sacred and holy event. As these two become one, the Bible teaches that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Have you not read that for this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife and shall become one flesh?" The Apostle Paul, speaking by the Holy Spirit, said, "Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church." And Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, "Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, does not brag, is not arrogant. Love endures all things. Love never fails." Okay, at this time we're going to do the ring exchange. Okay, y'all ready?
Yes.
All right. Hey, Xavion and Amanda, you will now give and receive rings as symbols of your vows of faith and love. As you exchange these rings, remember the purity of your love and the unending circle symbolizing the unending vows that you are now taking. Wear these rings always as a precious reminder of this sacred and holy occasion that you committed your love and your life to one another. Xavion, place this ring on Amanda's finger and repeat after me. Stand right there. Thanks. Amanda.
I give this ring to you.
As a symbol of my commitment to you.
As a symbol of my commitment to you.
And as a token of my conviction.
As a token of my conviction.
That the Lord is in his perfect will.
And the Lord is in his perfect will.
Has brought us together.
Has brought us together.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Okay. Amanda, place this ring on Xavion's finger and then repeat after me. Awesome. Good job. Xavion, I give this ring. To you as a symbol of my commitment to you. And as a token of my conviction. That the Lord in His perfect will. Has brought us together. In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. Okay. All right. So at this time, we're going to do something a little bit different. You had a little bitty card on your seat. This is going to be what's referred to as a unity cross. And we're going to do this unity cross now. So at this time, Xavion and Amanda will assemble the unity cross. This is a beautiful piece, except for me. Okay, they're going to assemble this Unity Cross. This is a beautiful sculpture that's going to be placed in their home for many years to come. They will look at this and they will continue to remember this day and what happened on this day. Okay, so in Genesis chapter 1, we read that God created man in his own image. That means that he created man to be strong. To be a protector of the wife and the family. Okay. The outer form of the Unity Cross represents strength, represents leadership, and protection of the man. The book of Ephesians reminds husbands to love their wives as Christ also loved the church and completely given himself for her. As well, in Genesis 2:23-23, it states that the woman was taken from the man, the bride's piece of the Unity Cross. This represents the beauty,
okay,
and the many capabilities of the woman. It was designed with intricate detail and is to be placed inside of this other cross and completing the sculpture, representing for us the two becoming one.
Another page will be inside of that.
Okay. Okay, to complete this sculpture, representing the couple's covenant, they're going to place three pegs to hold it together. These pegs represent the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, showing God's place in this covenant and the security and completeness that our only Heavenly Father can give. The scriptures teach us that a three-stranded cord is not easily broken. It's in Ecclesiastes 4:12. Matthew 19:5-6 states, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has formed together, let no one separate." At this time, who giveth this woman to be married to this man? Okay, we're going to go through the traditional vows now. Okay, go ahead and come together and hold your hand. Okay, do you, Xavion, in the presence of God and these assembled witnesses, take Amanda to be your lawful wedded wife? And do you promise to love and to cherish her in sickness and in health and in prosperity and in adversity? And do you promise to be to her all things a true and faithful husband, to cleave unto her and to her only as long as life shall last?
I do.
Say louder for the people.
Okay. Amanda, do you, Amanda, in the presence of God and those assembled witnesses, take Xavion to be your lawful wedded husband? And do you promise to love and to cherish him in sickness and in health, in prosperity and in adversity? And do you promise to be to him in all things a true and faithful wife, to cleave unto him and to him only as long as life shall last?
I do.
Okay, Xavion and Amanda, you can never be fully married to one another until you're thoroughly married to Christ. Without Christ in his indwelling spirit, you will never be able to share your total life together. For as your love for Christ grows, so will your love for each other. For the Bible teaches that marriage should exemplify the relationship of Christ with His church. And the relationship is primarily a spiritual one. It is the union of our spirits that gives the foundation of marriage. For as the Holy Spirit resurrected your human spirit and placed you into the body of Christ, tonight He will join you together as husband and wife. Tonight you will be husband and wife, not only in the eyes of the law, but in the eyes of Almighty God. Xavion, you may kiss your bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Xavion and Amanda Johnson.
Woo!